Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Secretary, for joining us here today. Knowing that this morning's topic is on higher education, I'll reserve my questions about pre-K for this afternoon. But I want to talk about sexual harassment and assault on campuses. This is a very hot issue in the Capitol right now. There's been 11 bills introduced so far in the House and 5 bills introduced in the Senate, mostly by women of the House and Senate, to deal with the issues of harassment and assault in a broader way. 6 of those bills have been referred to the Education Committee, and they mostly deal with harassment and assault at our institutions of higher education. So my first question for you, the General Assembly has appropriated support for the It's On Us campaign. I know this is something that the governor has been very vocal on. Can you talk about how that initiative is going, who received those grants, and what kind of outcomes we've seen to date?
Absolutely. First, I want to thank the General Assembly and thank you for your support in addressing the issue of sexual assault on campus and ensuring, you know, that sexual assault and you know, sexual violence is not part of any student's higher education experience. First, you know, I think we're extremely proud, both through the legislative perspective as well as being a member of the administration, that Pennsylvania is one of, you know, the few and one of the first states to adopt It's On Us as a It's On Us PA as a statewide campaign. And over the course of the past 2 years, being able to invest upwards of $2 million to engage in a number of initiatives on college campuses and looking at both partnerships with K-12 institutions. First, you know, I think when you it's important for me to share numbers. You know, we have impacted, you know, the lives of, oh, you know, well over 100,000, you know, individuals on college campuses across across the Commonwealth. We've really chipped away at the stigma for those who want to report or may have been bystanders on this issue by better informing colleges and campuses and victims and those who are witness of a crime around the barriers to reporting that crime. We've also been much more mindful in creating safe space, both socio-emotionally and actual physical safe space in colleges and campuses. Throughout this campaign, I was trying to flip through to find the page of the list of recipients quickly, but I don't want to spend too much time doing that. But you know, I'll absolutely forward the list of grant recipients to the General Assembly. But you know, I do have to share, over the course of the past 2 years, and we look to continue to change the narrative, you know, around sexual assault. First, make it clear it's not acceptable and will not be tolerated. Secondly, we understand we have to create a safe space for victims. And lastly, we have to counsel, you know, students on college campuses and K-12 institutions around what's right and what's not right, and what's healthy behavior and what's not healthy behavior, both for those who might engage in the behavior, but also for those who are witnessing the behavior, so they're much more likely to stand up, report, and hopefully stop and engage aggressively.
So, follow-up question. You said we've impacted the lives of over 100,000 people. Is that people who've been educated or people who've actually reported harassment or assault?
So those are individuals that have been educated. Okay. I want to say upwards of 80,000-plus students have engaged already through the program. And then it's also those who are facilitating, you know, the programs, which is upwards, you know, almost 20,000 individuals who have been facilitating the grants in the process.
And do you, Mr. Secretary, have any statistics on how many incidences of assault have been reported on our college campuses?
Not off the top of my head. That's absolutely a number I don't want to misspeak, but I'll absolutely forward that along.
And that would be very helpful. And one of the things that we've learned as we've dived into this issue here is that even getting a victim or survivor to the point of being willing to report takes a lot of support. So I'd be curious to know those statistics. A follow-up question. These 6 bills that have been so far introduced by members of the House and referred to the Education Committee, have you had a chance to take a look at any of these bills?
So now our team is absolutely, you know, looked and identified some of the alignment area of the bills. This is something that is personal and you know, the Department of Education is passionate about and will continue to stand at the ready to inform and engage appropriately.
Wonderful. And I know that some of the bills have been referred to the Labor Committee. The majority chairman has pledged to hold a full-day hearing on these bills this spring. I'm hoping that the majority education chair in the House will do the same on the bills that have been referred to the Education Committee.
And I thank you for really taking this on and championing this cause. I mean, you've been front and center, and you know, it's greatly it's noticed and greatly appreciated. Thank you.
Well, I think it's time for us to tell victims that we believe them and that we will fight for them here in this Capitol or anywhere in the Commonwealth. Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you.